This is Coffee Conversation.
Hootie, who are you? Hootie, who are you? Hootie, who are you? They can't hear me. I turn my mic up so they can feel me.
Hootie,
who are you? Hootie, who are you? Hootie, who are you? They can't hear me. I turn my mic up so they can feel me.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Coffee Conversations with your host, Todd T-Luv Davis. Listen, on today's segment, I got a very, very special guest that's here, and he has made a meme go completely viral. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, I am here to welcome you all to Coffee Conversations, none other than my man, Mr. Elijah Rutland. That's right, he's joining us for Coffee Conversation. And he's going to share his story of where he come from and, you know, just how he has taken this meme, this cartoon meme, and has inspired a whole bunch of other creators and entrepreneurs that's following. So, Elijah, tell your story, man.
Like, from the beginning?
From the beginning, man. From the beginning.
Basically. Well, my name is Elijah Rutland. I'm 19. I'm from Macon originally. I graduated from Central in 2017. And now I'm a sophomore at VMU. So pretty much the way the meme came about was prior to that, I've been drawing and doing my whole art thing for about 3 years. And so the original meme, the raw character, it was already kind of popular, and I thought it was pretty funny. And so usually what I like to do with my art is find a way to take what people know and then kind of blend it with something that I can relate to.
Right.
And like other artists and stuff can relate to. And so when I saw that, I thought it'd be a good idea to draw them like myself. And in the original meme, the caption said that people really out here thinking that I make free art. And you know, a lot of artists and entrepreneurs and stuff can relate to people who want stuff for free. So I just thought it'd be funny to draw like that.
And for people that don't understand or don't know what the Black Roth is, it's the guy that's looking out the window, you know, with the face. So tell them about that and how you just came up onto the scene.
I just thought it'd be funny to draw him like myself. So I changed the skin. I changed the skin color. I changed the hair.
So that wasn't the original Black character.
The original character isn't Black. He's, I'm not sure what ethnicity he is, but he had blue hair.
Okay.
And his skin was,
so you made him to kind of, like, look, you say, it looked like you. Yeah,
look like me pretty much.
Yeah, which was crazy, because I think they found somebody on social media that looked like that too. So
and the whole time I was drawing this, there was no inclination that, oh, this is going to be viral.
Right.
It was just another drawing.
Having fun with
it. I thought I was just going to post it. I was going to get however many likes it would get.
Yeah.
I'll just keep going. And then, so I posted it. As a matter of fact, I almost didn't post it because I didn't want to post it if people not think it's funny. And, you know, but I just went ahead and posted it. And then I posted it on Twitter first. And when I went to sleep, I think it had about 20 or so retweets.
And then 20, just 20 period, 20,000?
20, just 20.
Okay,
So I was just like, okay, I guess it kind of is what it is. And then after I posted on Twitter, I put it on Instagram and Facebook. And then like the next day, I woke up with like 50 tags on Facebook. Because people were like remixing it, so they'll take the original one to add box braids or add the little finger waves or add dreads.
And just start adding on to the character.
So then I was surprised because I didn't think any of that would happen. And then after that kept happening, then I was seeing people who were reposting it, but instead of the 20, I think my original post ended with like maybe 600 retweets, which was a lot to me at the time.
Right.
But then I see other people post it, they're getting 15,000 and
60,000. Yeah.
So I'm like,
yeah, wait a minute. I'm the one that put it out there.
So I wouldn't say I was mad. I was more frustrated because going broad was something I wanted to do.
Right.
And I tried to do it in the past, but it didn't work. So I'm just like, whatever. I'm just going to post my stuff, and whoever likes it, whoever doesn't.
Yeah.
It's kind of is what it is. And so once, actually, another thing, when it, more people were seeing it, or when other people, I should say, were going viral, like my friends, other people who had been following me, they were posting it, they were tagging me in the comments, all that kind of stuff. Like, you even got on like WorldStar and The Shade Room, and, you know, they got 20 million followers just right. on Instagram. And so, in the midst of all that, people, and then as the days were going on, it was just more and more and more and more and more. And then, because it went from just being on my page and my friends' pages to, I was seeing it on Twitter just like any other picture.
Right.
Like I didn't make it.
Like you did make it. Yeah, and yeah, so, yeah. So at this point, you're like, hold on, wait a minute, what?
And, you know, I watched a lot of like documentaries, and so I'm sure you've seen like the TLC, Toni Braxton. New Edition, what they all created stuff, didn't get credit for it.
Right.
Didn't get to reap the full benefits of it. So, you know, I've seen those enough times to where I knew I didn't want to be like that. I didn't want to create something and not get the full benefits from it. So for I had been doing the whole art thing. And I kind of got, I don't say big, my name had gotten around.
Yeah. You know, you're not Elijah Rutland now. Now you're that guy. Hey, that's that guy that does.
Yeah. So like, pretty much like around Macon mainly, and even at FAMU, like if I was walking around with a pair of shoes, I did. A lot of times people would recognize me. And they'll say, well, a lot of times they were staring at the same thing.
Okay.
Or just, you know.
Yeah.
All right. And when they did, they say, aren't you the one who makes the shoes?
Right.
But that'll be because I had on the shoes.
Speaking of which, let's direct the attention to the custom-made Fix My Soul shoes. That's the is that Dragon Ball Z?
Yeah.
So you, this is what you created as well, right?
Yeah. This is my main.
That's your main one?
I've been doing this since 2015. And I didn't start any kind of digital art until February of last year. So that's why this whole thing is so crazy, because I just started.
Yeah.
It hasn't even been a year.
Hasn't even been a year.
Since I've been doing digital stuff. But like I was saying before, if I had on like my shoes or a jacket or whatever, people could recognize me off that, which I understood because I had it on. But now, like yesterday, I was at McAllister's. And I had on like a family sweatshirt, some black pants, and just some regular shoes. And I was about to go place my order, and the guy said, "Ain't you the boy who been doing this?"
Yeah. See, you're that guy now.
And so it's been happening a lot, but I guess I kind of underestimated the reach of it and how many people saw it, just because I'm pretty, I guess, laid back.
Right.
I was never really out in the spotlight or whatever, but that's been pretty different,
I imagine. So I mean, you know, like you say, you started from a creative standpoint, and now it's a popularity standpoint, and I'm pretty sure you're getting several invites, and people just really want to hear your story, and that's what drew me to you. Like, I wanted to know your story, you know, based off of that celebrity, but also to let the people know that you're from Macon and you're homegrown right here. So, you know, you have some pretty, you know, humble roots or whatnot. And going forward, you know, as far as like entrepreneurialism, like did you have a familiar take on the entrepreneurial spirit, or?
Yeah. Well, but before all this happened, you know, I had done a lot of like talks, kind of classes about, because I guess the good thing about what I'm doing now is that I'm still young,
right?
And I just graduated high school and all this stuff, So it's easier for to talk to younger people, even older people too, but mainly I like to focus on younger people because it's like they can see themselves through me.
Right.
And like it's the difference between like a 45-year-old like 45-year-old CEO or whatever coming to talk to high schoolers and making about entrepreneurship.
Right.
Versus someone who was just there.
Just there, yeah. Yeah, yeah. And that's a heavy influence. So have you had a invites to come speak to schools here in Macon or Tallahassee?
Yeah, I've done a lot. Been able to do a lot at FAMU and in Tallahassee, like around the community, but mainly in the school because the good thing about everything is that I started early, so I had time to mess up, make mistakes while I was still at home, and I was able to rebound. Versus if I started, you know, when I was 35, I had kids, bills, all that stuff. So I was able to get in the swing of things.
Yeah, yeah, you kind of get the kinks out the way.
Yeah. So when I came into FAMU, I pretty much had everything together.
Mm-hmm.
Or I thought I did. But
Hey, man. Every 18 and 19 year old, I was there. Listen, I thought I had it all together at 19. But now I had, you know, I ain't got it together, you know. So it's a learning curve that you went on ahead and got it out the way right then. So now you're putting everything into a business perspective right now.
Yeah.
Right?
And so getting that kind of attention helped me get more focus on making this my job because the other reason, why I started painting was because, like I said before, I would always want the Jordans and Nikes and all this stuff, but I didn't have my own money. And when I was 15, I never had a job.
Mm-hmm.
And from the time I was about 14 to 15, I was trying to get hired at Publix. And when I was 14, I applied, but they said they wouldn't hire you till 15. Then when I turned 15, they didn't hire me, so I didn't want to. I was like, whatever.
Yeah.
So I started painting. Then from now, that's been my only form of work.
Mm-hmm.
So just that, and being able to do something that I love and also support myself off of it has been amazing. And that's really been like the thing that's one of the things that's drawn people to my story. And something I've been able to stress and focus on, because like last summer I did a class at the Boys and Girls Club in Opelika. /Auburn.
Okay. Now that was in
last summer.
And what about Tallahassee? Miami?
In Auburn.
In Auburn.
Alabama.
Auburn, Alabama. Okay.
Yeah, my aunt, she actually went to Tuskegee, and so She's been like one of my biggest fans. So she knew the director of the Boys and Girls Club, and the director is actually another artist, and so she wanted to bring me out to talk to the kids because they were kind of high school, like around 10th grade.
Mm-hmm.
So and the most important thing, the thing I like the most is when I see other younger kids who might be drawing too, but not thinking much of it, and they just, you know, draw me in there. But then when they see I turn drawing into shoes, jackets, all this stuff, they can kind of like give them motivation. I want to have kids DM me and say, oh, I've been looking at your work and all this stuff, and you inspired me to keep drawing. That's really what I like the most, because I kind of stumbled upon this on my own. So when I can help other kids or even adults get into it and find something positive to do, something that they love to do, that's really what I like the most about the whole entrepreneur thing and the art thing.
So for that entrepreneur that aspiring entrepreneur that wants to get started but also wants to know how to monetize a gift or a talent and then maximize their potential. How did you monetize Fix My Soul, Like Roth meme? How did you put a tag of income on it?
Well, the first thing I started doing was customizing shoes.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was like 15 when I first started doing this. And so the way I started was I would go to like Goodwill, get like a pair of $2 or $3 shoes. Then I would paint it, and then I would post it on Facebook.
That kid that's sitting at home right now watching Coffee Conversation, if you were to tell that adult that's watching Coffee Conversation, what would you tell them? What kind of keys to success or any kind of insight that you would give them to trust in something that they have inside of them to keep going? What is it that motivates you?
The most important thing, this is just in general, whether you're doing art, singing, dancing, whatever it is to keep going. Never stop creating whatever it is that you do. Because before all this happened, there was a lot of times where I thought I wanted to give up, but I just wanted to stop. The picture I thought was going to blow up didn't blow up, and I was mad at the world. And if I stopped at any point before this, I wouldn't be where I am today.
Mm-hmm.
And the main thing is just to find something that you love to do and just keep going. Even when, whether you have 10 followers, 10,000, 100,000, just keep going, because you never know who's watching you.
Exactly.
And you never know what can happen
from that.
Because I was thinking nothing of the Black Rock picture. I posted that, then I went from like 12,000 followers on Instagram to like 22 in like a week. And that was just off of one picture that I thought it was funny to me.
Yeah.
I didn't make it to go viral. I didn't make it. It was just another post.
Yeah. Now it's money in the bank. So Coffee Conversations, I want to thank you again, Elijah, for coming on. And let the world know how they can follow you on all social media platforms and what is it that you got coming up next.
Well, on all social media, my ad name is Fix My Soul. That's FIXMYSOLE. That's on Instagram and Twitter. Facebook is Fix My Soul, three separate words. And next, I'm working on some, I'll be at Minnesota in January 18th.
What's going on in Minnesota?
That's the Martin Luther King Day.
Okay, Martin Luther King weekend. Be looking for you in Minnesota. Okay, awesome, man. Well, I'm glad that you came to Coffee Conversation. I'm glad that you didn't take my DM as a joke and think that I was holding something else trying to con you out. Elijah, thank you so much, man. Merry Christmas to you and a happy new year. Listen, everybody, I want to encourage and inspire everyone out there, from small to big, to always, always think about the law of attraction. What is it that you want to attract? Do you want attention? Do you want celebrity status? Do you want finances? Whatever it is that you're doing, listening to Elijah's story and learn something from him. Because something that started off as something, you know, as a joke, turned into something that was really, really fantastic and influential. So now he's inspiring the minds of other entrepreneurs. And
today's two guests were phenomenal. It's Coffee Conversation with your boy T-Luv right here in the heart of Macon in the Mercer Village. And Earl's story, coming from the bottom of Bloomfield to the top of the real estate game, is one that is a true inspiration of starting at the bottom, and then you get to a certain place of prosperity and purpose. If you didn't take anything away from that story other than what it was that he did in real estate, one must always keep a perspective of prosperity. One must always look beyond the vision that is in the peripherals of where you're at right now. And coming from a place where Elijah came from, he was just doodling on Instagram. He was just doodling, using his creative ways to kind of gain attention to what it is that he was doing. A joke was then turned into millions of dollars. So both stories were very, very great, and seeing as though both of them from Macon and Middle Georgia. So Coffee Conversation is just that. We're getting the true, authentic story coming from authentic people and coming from an authentic place. So be tuned in to Coffee Conversation for more interviews, just like the ones that we had with Earl, just like the one we had with Elijah. It's your boy, T-Luv. We're right here at C-Beans. We're coming to a city and a state near you. We want to look for those entrepreneurs. We want to look for those small business owners. And we definitely want to look for those people of influence that will inspire and impact the nation with their stories. With that being said, we'll check y'all out on the next tip. Follow me at IMTLUV. That's IMTLUV. Coffee Conversations. It's coming 2019.
This is Coffee Conversations.